Hey guys, welcome back to 90 Feet From Home. I'm your host Ashley, and if this is your first time watching this show, this is a baseball YouTube channel meant to introduce you to all of the basic statistics, lingo, and different things that go into loving the game of baseball. Before we get too deep into this episode, I want to apologize if you can hear a rooster crowing in the background, because that's a thing that's happening right now as we speak. This is country life. Country life is fun. In today's episode, we're going to pick up where we left off with batting statistics. And I know the last thing I mentioned to you guys was OPS Plus, which was kind of a more advanced statistic on what we had been discussing. I'm going to link to that batting average video down below. The OPS Plus stuff is at the very end. And from there, you can kind of see the trajectory we're taking towards building a more all-encompassing batting statistic. So in today's episode, we're going to talk about three of those: wOBA, wRC, and wRC Plus. wRC and wRC Plus go hand in hand, so we're kind of going to just link those two together. I don't know, guys, man. Don't ask me. but we're gonna start with wOBA, which kind of picks up where OPS Plus leaves off, in that it tries to factor in all of the different aspects of a batter's performance in order to create a number that more accurately reflects their performance that season. wOBA stands for Weighted On Base Average. The goal of wOBA is to measure a player's offensive contributions per plate appearance. Much like how slugging percentage, when we looked into it in that original video, assigns a different value for each type of hit, like a double, a triple, or a home run, wOBA assigns a different value to all the different outcomes a player can have on plate that result in them getting on base. So basically, wOBA is kind of a combination of on-base percentage and slugging, and it adds numerical value to stuff like walks or hits by pitch, anything that basically results in that batter becoming a base runner. The difference here being that OBP only measures success if a walk or a hit is what gets that batter to the plate. So it's a little bit more refined, and like those other statistics we talked about, it does give a weighted value to things that are considered to be more valuable. So stuff like a home run has more value than a hit by pitch, and something like a double is going to have more value than a walk. For example, also something like an intentional walk is actually going to be subtracted from a player's walk total because they didn't have any particular say in whether or not they were walked. It's not a result of something they did. Technically, it is actually a result of something they did, because usually means they're such a good batter that the pitcher doesn't want to face them and would rather go to the next person in line. That's neither here nor there in calculating this particular statistic. And again, this is one of those insane formulas I'm not even going to bother to read out, but I will put down here so that you can see what it looks like. And it's a doozy. It's going to stretch all the way across the screen. So as you can see from that, or if you had a chance to actually look at it, non-intentional walks have the lowest value. That's represented by NIBB, non-intentional base on balls. And home runs have the highest value. So no surprises there. The valuations are very similar to what we saw in something like slugging. The goal here is to create a number that looks like batting average on that 1000 scale and is easy to read, but gives a more true reflection of what a player's been able to manage offensively in getting on base. For example, Nick Castellanos from the Detroit Tigers had a 263 wOBA last year, which would be considerably higher than something like his batting average. If we're looking at wOBA, we can consider it to be a much more true representation of a player's value than, say, something like OPS Plus, which is on-base plus slugging, which we again discussed in that original batting averages video. So from wOBA, we develop into something we call wRC, and from wRC, we get wRC Plus. And if you're going to focus on either of these two statistics, I highly recommend wRC Plus. Plus being the one you try to learn the most, because as of right now, it is considered to be the most true reflection of a player's actual ability, and you're going to see it used very frequently in baseball writing, and it is a good stat to know and to understand at a glance. So I'm going to talk about both wRC and wRC Plus, because like OPS and OPS Plus, they feed off of each other in that one becomes the other with adjusted park numbers. wRC is built on wOBA, so it takes a lot of those same things into account, with walks being considered the lowest value, home runs being considered the highest, and a various assignment of values therein. What wRC Plus then does is compares that player's wOBA to league average wOBA, and also factors in the number of plate appearances. So it's a little bit more in-depth. It also takes that average against league average. So that's wRC Plus at its most basic. And again, I'm going to throw that enormous, ridiculous calculation down below. And if you pause it, you can kind of get a sense for exactly where those numbers are lining up and what each individual calculation means, because you should know what each of those letters indicates. So with WRC plus, it's mostly wOBA and league average, and those are the dividing factors. But if you go back and look at wOBA, you can see where stuff like hits by pitch, one base, as in a single, home runs, intentional base on balls, and that sort of thing come into play. So now that you kind of understand how WRC is calculated, we can go back and look at some of the other stats we talked about, like OPS plus or ERA plus, where you're taking your basic ERA or OPS number and then calculating it against park factors. WRC plus does this same thing, taking into account parks to create a more true overall value of what that batter's productivity has been like for the season. And it gives you WRC plus as a number. Like most other statistics that end in that plus, it does have that same 100 scale to it. So for example, if a player has a 150 WRC plus, they were 50% better than league average, which is that 100. So that's how at a glance you understand what WRC plus means, very similar to those other adjusted numbers. And what WRC plus means is adjusted weighted runs created. I don't know if I mentioned what WRC meant and it's weighted runs created. So again, all the WRC plus means is that it's adjusted for park factors and gives us that 100 scale representation. So to understand why WRC plus is the most popular and probably the most currently complete picture of a batter's overall value, you have to look at what it's counting. So we've built our way up all the way from batting average to WRC plus, so you'll understand bits and pieces of this in that, like slugging, WRC plus adds weighted value to different types of hits, one base, two base, three base, home run. Then it also factors in stuff like walks, non-intentional hits by pitch, and that sort of thing, anything that would result in that batter getting onto base, and assigns different values for each of those particular events. So basically it factors any type of on-base event into one easy to read number and gives us that player's overall true value for a season. It also includes stuff like league average wOBA, so you can see how that player is faring against others that are playing at the same time. And then it also accounts for park factors. So basically, it's creating this perfect hybrid of batting average, on-base percentage, slugging, and then of course, on-base plus slugging, of OPS plus, and of wOBA. It's just this beautiful hybrid monster that brings all of those different things into one beautiful, easy-to-read number. So for example now, if you are going to look at a player's statistics, and you're on Fangraphs or something similar to that, and you see that WRC plus column, you can really, at a glance, just look at that and skip over the rest of the player's statistics for the season. And if they had, say, a 63 WRC plus, then you know that they were well below league average. But if they had a 163 WRC plus, you know that they were 63% better than all of the other players in the league. And that's considerable. And that is a very good player and one to watch out for. And that, guys, is wOBA, WRC, and WRC plus. I really like WRC plus. I know advanced statistics can be really hard to understand, but the second I kind of understood and appreciated what WRC plus was bringing all into one all-inclusive statistic, I started using it all the time. WRC plus is one of those beautiful batting statistics that really just gives you a quick, at-a-glance appreciation of what a batter has been able to do over the course of a season and of their career. Now, in another episode coming up, I'm going to talk about a new statistic that was created by Baseball Prospectus in 2018 called DRC plus, and it aims to be a step up from WRC plus, but because it's so new and hasn't been fully adopted by baseball writers or stats people, I'm going to give it its own episode because I think it would be an interesting one to learn about on its own. So I hope you enjoyed that episode. I hope you did not hear that rooster crowing throughout it, and I hope you'll come back next time for another new episode. In the meantime, if you would do me a favor and hit that subscribe button down below. You can also ring the bell if you'd like to be notified every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday when a new episode goes live. You can also follow me on social media, where I'm at 90 feet from home on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. People have sent me episode suggestions via Facebook and Twitter now. I haven't gotten any on Instagram, but I'm also really bad at updating Instagram, so I'm going to try and get better at that. I hope you'll also leave a comment down below if you have an episode about something you'd like to learn more about. If you just want to leave a comment on this episode, do you also love WRC plus? I know I'm a big fan. I hope you enjoyed this episode and will come back in the future, and we'll see you guys next time. Thanks so much. Bye.